Hey everyone, welcome back. It's Dale here from Crazy Good PowerPoint. Today I'm going to show you how to set up an interactive map in PowerPoint that will allow you to click on whatever region you like without having to go through the slides in order. So let's check it out. Okay, so this is the slide we're going to work with today, which is the same slide deck that we used in the previous video. As you can see here, we have a map of New Zealand and we were morphing through into each of these different regions and then back out again. What we're going to do now is I've created a duplicate of this slide, and in here I've also put a button here which we're going to use later, which we haven't set a link for yet, but we will do that later, and as well as this region name little card that will move around the screen depending on what region we're going to name. And we're going to highlight the population for each region as well. So I'll show you how I've set this up. I'll come to Arrange and go to Selection Pane. And over here you'll see that this image here, which is a grouped vector image of New Zealand, or it can be any map that you want to choose from. And you'll see that it's actually made up of all different shapes. So what I've done to make this easier is I've named all of these shapes for the specific regions that they represent. I've also done the same for all of the little elements here, so the pink bar, the region name, and this home button. This button here is going to be when we duplicate all of these slides, at any point in time we'll be able to click this to come back to this home screen, and I'll show you how that works in a moment. So the first thing we're going to do is come in here, we're going to right click, and we'll insert new slide. Now we want the layout to include the title, so we'll select title only. I'll zoom out a bit, and I want this title to actually be off the slide, because we're not actually using it on the slide, but what's going to happen is we'll add it and use it as a label when we're linking to the slides, which makes things a lot more easy to see. I'm also going to come back here, and I'm going to grab this pink button and the region name. So I'll group both of those, copy them in, and we're done. Now there are 15 regions that I need to zoom into with the interactive map, so I'm going to have to create 15 instances of this slide. Now we actually have to create the slides first that we need to target, because when we come to this map, we're going to actually get each of these regions targeted to each of these slides. So the blank slides need to exist first for us to do that. So I'll come back here, and what we'll do, so we don't have to do this multiple times, is we're going to make this button link always back to the main map. And when we duplicate it, it will always have the same setting. Now you can do this by going to Insert, Action, and then we click Hyperlink to, and then we want to select Slide. And we'll see, we want to select it to Slide 5 as our home slide, so I'll select Slide 5. And click OK. Now I'm going to create 15 versions of this. So we've got one already, so we just need 14 more. So I'll quickly just do that now by holding down Control D, and I'll do that 14 more times. It doesn't matter if I do too many, because we can always delete the others out later. Beautiful. We will have all of our duplicated slides. Next thing we need to do is update all of the titles, the different region names. Now you can do it by clicking on the slide and clicking up here, but the faster way is if you go to View and then come to Outline View, we'll see the slides here. So this is the first one, slide number 5, and then we have slide 6. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy from a different notepad that I have the slide names here, and as you can see, as I copy them here, it updates the title as well. And this will be our labels that we'll refer to. I'll keep working through the list, and I'll work through the rest now so you don't have to watch me and get bored in doing so. So I'll be back in a moment. All right, so now that that's done, we'll come back to the normal view and we'll move back up into our first slide again. Now what we want to do is we want to set all of the hyperlinks now on this one slide. And once we've done that, we can copy and paste this map image into the rest of the slides, and that saves us having to set the links every single time. So to do that, we'll just zoom in a little bit, And within here, I'm going to select the first region first. Now, before I showed you that you can go to Insert, then Action, and then go to hyperlink to the slide details here. Now, you can do that for each one. I'll show you a faster way. Simply right click, go to Link, and go to Place in this document. And here you'll see all of the slide names. Now, this is why it was so good actually putting all of the titles in for the slides, for the regions, because now it's very easy to pick where we need to link this to. Now, these are a little bit out of order. So this first one we want to link to is Northland. So I'll select that one and click OK. And the same thing for the next one. So I'll move down, I'll right click, go to Link. Now, this is the region of Auckland. So I'll find Auckland, select Auckland, and I'll click OK. Great. I'll continue now and I'll add all of the links and I'll come back to you in a moment. Alrighty, so now we've got all of the links added to the slide. So what we're going to do is copy this grouped map by pressing Ctrl C. And I'm going to go to next slide and I'm just going to paste it in using Ctrl V. Now I have the aspect ratio for this grouped map locked. So if you want to know how to do that, you just right click and go to Format Shape, go to Size, and then click Lock Aspect Ratio. And what we're going to do is just change the width to 25 centimeters. And that will also mean the height will change to the same ratio as well. Perfect. I'll just slide that here. Now it doesn't matter where it's located right now. I'll just zoom out a bit so you can see what's happening. But what we're going to do is we're going to copy this into each slide like so, by just clicking and pushing Ctrl V and pasting. I'll quickly go through and do the rest of those. Great, so now we've copied map into every single slide. I'll come back to the top. Just zoom this in a little bit. And the first thing we're going to do is on this first slide, I don't need the region name because this is the home map, so I'm going to delete that one. And I'm going to come to our first one, which is West Coast. So the West Coast is this region here. So I'm going to right click this, change the fill to pink, and change the outline to pink as well. And I want to move this region just like we did in the previous video. So this region is roughly in the center of the map. So to guide us with that, I'm going to go to View and then to Guides and just try and get the best I can there. And then I'm going to slide over the region name and I type West Coast. And then I'm just going to grab the population for the West Coast, which is 32,000. Great. And then all we have to do is continue this process for the next slide as well. So for Wellington, which is this one, and I can see that here because I've got Wellington highlighted. Same thing, same process. Make it pink, change the outline to pink as well, move it up to here, grab the region name and bring it across. We might bring the region name to this side because it might work a bit better. Just rename this box. Now I can see the population of Wellington is a bit more than West Coast. It's 542,000 at the moment. Great. So just so you can see where we're up to at the moment, if I click on Wellington, it goes straight to the Wellington slide. If I go to West Coast, it takes me straight to the West Coast slide. And as you can see, there's no animation or anything happening yet because we haven't set that up. And we'll look at that in a moment. Okay, so I'm going to continue through. I'm going to work through all of these slides and add them all in. And when we come back, we'll add the morph transition and we'll be done. Back in a moment. Perfect. All the slides are set up now. So all we need to do is set up the morph transition for all of these slides so that when we click on these regions, it will animate beautifully between them. So I'll select the first one, go down to the bottom, hold down shift and press the bottom one. Then come up to transitions and select morph. Now I already know that this morph transition is a bit slow, so I'm going to change this to about 1.25 seconds. So I'll knock this back a bit. And we are done. So let's check that out. So So when we're presenting to anyone, you can click on any region you want now. And as I hover over these, you'll see my mouse turns to a hand. So I'll click on here and it animates in to Taranaki and I can see the population. And from here, I can navigate to anywhere I want. I can ask questions and just keep going. So I'll go down to where Wellington is. I can come over here to the West Coast, down to Canterbury, and so forth. If I want to return back to the main map, I have this home button. So I come back here and it takes me back to the home map at any point in time. Fantastic. Well, I hope you like this video. It just shows you a different way of doing things with morphing, but also this is really useful if you're presenting in front of people via maybe a webinar call or just in class. If you'd like to see more videos like this, I'd really love your support. If you can click that subscribe button, and that really inspires me just to keep releasing more videos for you. If you have any questions, please reach out in the comments below. And as always, I'll provide the free download link in the description below. Thanks heaps, and I'll catch you in the next video.